In another recent video, we went over the enhanced features many of our in-home Wi-Fi connected displays offer. We'll link to that up here and in the description below. But today, we will specifically be talking about data streams, what they are, where they will show up, and how to find and edit them in your LacrosseView app. So, let's get started. Data streams allow you to receive additional information on your in-home weather station or alarm clock. Typically, this will be in the form of extra weather data or custom messages that will all cycle through with the time and date on your display. The Weather Service streams will provide internet data for metrics such as air quality, cloud cover, sunrise or sunset times, UV index, and much more. The text streams, on the other hand, give you the option of posting reminders and other useful custom messages. To set up a data stream, open the LacrosseView app and find your display's device page. You can do this by swiping left and right, or by tapping the menu icon and finding its name in your device's list. Once on this display device page, swipe up to reveal additional data, and ultimately your data stream section. Once there, tap the blue stream icon in the upper right. This will bring you to your data stream page, where you'll be able to add and edit these items. To get started, tap the Add Stream Item button at the bottom, and then select between a text stream or a weather service stream. To start, let's add a text stream. This will bring up a new page with two text fields for us to enter in our custom message. In most cases, these will be limited to about 10 all caps characters per field, including spaces, and will not allow for any special characters. But let's say your special someone has a birthday coming up. You can add this stream to surprise them with your custom message. Simply type what you'd like each line to say, and tap Save in the upper right. Here you can now see our Happy Birthday text stream listed in our active section. Let's now add a few weather service streams to see how these will function. To do this, I'll tap the Add Stream Item button again, and this time select Weather Service Stream. A list of available weather stream options will then appear. Select the one you'd like to add, and then tap Save in the upper right. It may take a few seconds here to get this loaded in, but once complete, you should now see this listed in your active section. We'll do this with a few more here to demonstrate some additional things. Alright, now that we have a good number and variety of streams in here, we can see that only 3 streams are available to be placed in the active section for this display. The number of active streams will vary by station model and will be noted in the app below the last active stream. There are no limits to the number of inactive streams you can save. Keeping items here versus deleting them simply saves time from having to find and re-add them later. You can easily edit any stream by tapping on it, swap streams between the active and inactive sections by pressing and holding the move icon to the right, and then dragging it to the correct spot, and delete streams by tapping the red minus icon to the left, and then delete to the right. Android users, you can remove streams by just swiping them to the left. Another feature this data stream page gives you is the pin option, found in the top left. Tapping this will bring up a list of all active and inactive streams you have saved. This function may be most useful on specific days, like birthdays for instance, where you'd really like one stream emphasized. Pinning a stream will override all other streams and be the only one cycled with the time and date on your in-home display. This will continue until unpinned. To execute any data stream change, you'll also want to tap Done in the upper right. This will bring up a message letting you know that your adjustments have been saved and will update on your display shortly. After doing this, you should also notice that the Data Streams section on this device page now lists the number of active streams. In our case, since we have a stream pinned, it notes that we have one item exclusively displayed. To unpin a stream, tap the blue stream icon again, and then unpin in the top left. This will bring you back to your normal Data Stream page and set your display to go back to your previous active stream setup. For most users, the previous set of steps should have your data streams up and running correctly. But if you're having issues, the following troubleshooting information may be helpful. First up, if you're not seeing this data stream section within your LacrosseView app, there could be a few reasons for this. You'll first want to make sure you're on your display device page within the app, as sensors will not offer a data stream function. The device name at the top, as well as the glyph image, should help clue you in. Next, you'll also need to be the owner of the display within your LacrosseView app. Devices shared with you by another user will not give you the ability to update information on their display. And finally, if you're still not seeing this option in the app, it is likely that your display model unfortunately does not offer this data stream feature. To confirm, you can always look this up on our website using the search function at the top. It is also important to note that all models will be different in terms of the amount, type, and where this extra information will appear on the display itself. Currently, the Weather Service streams will update a minimum of 4 times per day on their own, and future devices and updates may offer additional abilities that further enhance these specs. We hope this video helped you to better understand how our data stream feature works. For more information about other connected display or app features, we recommend reviewing our LacrosseView support playlist linked in the top right or in the video description. If you should have additional questions, feel free to post them in the comments section below or reach out to our support staff directly. We assure you we are here to help and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. Thanks again for choosing LaCrosse Technology.